Hello and welcome to the session on Introduction to Business Intelligence. This is Dr. Anita Pujar, Professor of Computer Science and Engineering Department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of this session, students are able to understand what is business intelligence and what are the different types of business intelligence applications. In brief, business intelligence is analyzing the past data and come up with the strategies to improve the future of the company. Now, in day-to-day business operations, company generates huge amount of data either through IT systems such as ERP, CRM or MIS and through manual operations. This huge amount of generated data is called as raw data. Now, direct analysis cannot be done on the raw data. Raw data needs to be transformed into meaningful information for the analysis. The process of converting the raw data into meaningful information is called as business intelligence system. Now, this meaningful information is transformed to come up with the strategies to improve the future of the company. The future of the company can be improved in terms of more profits and increasing the stability of the company. Now, the meaningful information generated by business intelligence is used by the top management of the people of the company, and they come up with the strategies or actions that result in more profits of the company and high stability of the company. More profits can be in terms of increasing the revenue and reducing the cost. Pause the video for a minute, think and write. Is business intelligence only a tool? So business intelligence is not only a tool or not only a process. It is a framework or an approach which is a combination of people, technologies, applications, processes, architectures, softwares and tools, and services. Now, what is the objective of business intelligence? Delivering the information to the end users is not the objective of business intelligence. Instead, the objective of business intelligence is to deliver the right information in right format at right time to right users. Now let's see the functions of business intelligence. Business intelligence performs three functions. It provides views, it provides business performance management, and it can generate reports. Views can be of three types: past views, current views, or predictive views. The predictive view of the company can be generated using the trends in the past. Business performance management can be done in terms of KPIs. KPIs are the key performance indicators. They help to measure the current performance of the company against the set goals. KPIs are very important for the management of people of the company. They are very keen to keep the track of KPIs because KPIs allows to compare the current business with that of the market trends. Business intelligence also helps to generate the reports. That is, they use tools for generating the reports of online queries and also for generating the batch reports. This is called as data visualization. So, functions of business intelligence can be summarized as follows. They help in the prediction of future based on past data. They create KPIs. They identify and set benchmarks for the varied processes. Organizations can identify market trends and spot business problems that need to be addressed. They also provide data visualization that enhances the quality of decision making. To achieve the functions, business intelligence has to use the technical approaches. They have to take the support of software tools. Here, three software tools have been shown: benchmarking software tools, data mining tools, and predictive analysis tools. BI tools in general perform the following things. They are used for data analysis. They are used to generate reports. They are used for generating summaries. They are used for generating dashboards, maps, graphs, and charts. BI works in three steps. First, it collects the data from external sources such as multiple OLTP databases and flat files. OLTP databases can be CRM systems, ERP systems, MIS systems, and so on. The collected data needs to be cleaned and transformed into data warehouse. The information in the data warehouse is now ready for analysis. This information can also be used to generate the data cubes or data marts depending on the various business processes of the company. Data marts and data cubes consist of aggregated information. Hence, they work on the queries faster than the queries on the data warehouses. BIs can generate reports based on the information in the data warehouse, or they can use that information for further analysis, or they can also provide the data visualization. Now let's see the example of business intelligence of a retail shop here. The example is shown in two parts. On the left, it is online transaction processing, which consists of different OLTP databases. The first one is the product database, second one is the advertising database, and the third one is a customer demographic database. On the right side, online analytical processing section is shown. That is, there is a data warehouse here, and the different types of analysis are performed. Business intelligence first collects the data from product database, advertising database, and customer demographic database. It cleans it and then stores the information into data warehouse. Now, the information in the data warehouse is called as meaningful information. Now, three types of analysis are performed on this data warehouse. First analysis is whether adding a new product line or changing a product price can change the revenue of the system. Second analysis is whether change in advertising or increasing the radio budget of the products can increase the customers of the company. And the third analysis is, can the change in the customer profile, that is increase in the customer credit limit or change in the customer salary level, can hike the sales of a high-priced product. In this way, various analysis can be performed on the information in the data warehouse. Some of the common kinds of business intelligence systems are EIS, that is executive information systems. This information systems is used by senior executives to check the performance of the company and identify the scope for the improvement or identify the problems that need to be addressed for improving the business of the company. DSS, decision support systems, they are the interactive software-based systems which help in decision-making process. They use the data from the various sources for making the decisions for the further improvement of the company. Third, MIS, that is Management Information Systems. These produce the regular reports for the management at every level, and they contain the information about all the financial positions of the company. Geographic Information Systems, they capture, store, analyze, and display the data related to the positions on the Earth's surface. They help the individuals or the organizations to understand the spatial patterns and the relationships. Online analytical processing and multidimensional analysis, they do the dimensions analysis of all the data collected from various sources and help in decision-making process. Customer relationship management, they store the data related to the customers of the company. They help in achieving the proper customer relationship, assist in customer retention and driving the sales growth. These are some of the references. Thank you.